Hello, I'm Eric Archer, the Science Content Strategy Manager at Texas Instruments. Today we're going to explore Mendelian genetics and the expression of genes, or gene expression. This will help to answer questions you may have about why children have some of their mother's or father's physical features. So for example, eye color, hair texture and color, cleft chin, which is that little sort of divot some people have in their chin, whether your earlobes are detached or attached. Some people have detached lobes like I do, and others are attached to their necks. They're all fun physical traits you can sort of explore with your family and find out, you know, did you get that from mom or did you get that from dad? And then your siblings as well. Look at some of those physical differences that we mentioned a bit ago with your siblings to figure out where do those features come from. So in this particular lesson today, we're going to be looking at the physical height, that is how short or tall something is, but we're using a simulation of the height of plants. In this case, we're using pea plants. So we're using that as a way to sort of understand the rules of Mendelian genetics, which is named after an Austrian monk named Gregor Mendel, who observed over a number of years differences in these pea plants, the seed texture, the height, color of the flower, and determined a set of rules. Today, it won't take you years. You'll get to learn about those sets of rules in about 20 minutes. So looking forward to this lesson. I know you are as well, because like I said, once you learn about how this system works, you're gonna be looking at things a little bit differently. To use this lesson on your own, instead of just watching the video, you can actually interact with the simulation on your own. You just need to get the TI-Nspire CX Premium software, which you can do at our website. And then you need to get the lesson, which is all free, the lessons are all free, from www.scienceinspired.com. And the lessons can be used with either the Premium CX Premium software or with a TI-Nspire CX or CX2 graphing calculator. Okay, all right, so let's get started. Okay, so we're in the software, we're in the TI-Nspire CX Premium software, and I have a file open called Punnett P Predictor, and we're gonna go slide by slide to explore, you know, the rules of Mendelian genetics using a Punnett square, and the Punnett square was named after Reginald Punnett. He was an English scientist who sort of took what Mendel did and many others and figured out a way to more easily explore possibilities of what offspring will express in terms of physical traits. So this page talks about alleles. That's this word right here, alleles. An allele is an alternative form of a gene located at a specific position on a specific chromosome. Which is on DNA. So in humans, we have 23 pairs of chromosomes. And the reason we say pairs of chromosomes is because you get one from mom and one from dad for each of the 23 sets. And so those mom's chromosome 1, dad's chromosome 1 come together to form a pair for chromosome 1. And all the way up to, all 23 pairs of chromosomes, half come from mom, half come from your father. All right, so an allele is a variation of what's being expressed. So think of a gene as being sort of this chunk of DNA that sends out instructions for, you know, RNA to make a protein. Or a set of proteins, and those proteins are what are expressed. And so the gene may code for a particular trait, we'll say height, how big or how short or how tall something is in this case, and the allele will be that variation. So there could be a short allele for plant height or a tall allele for plant height. So the allele is the variation of the trait that is expressed from the gene. So, you know, maybe pause, replay that section just so you can understand the differences between genes and allele. An allele is a variation of a trait that is expressed from a chunk of DNA known as a gene, okay? All right, so hopefully that made sense. Alleles determine traits that can be passed on from parents to offspring, like we mentioned many of those earlier. In many cases, a trait is determined by one pair of alleles, one allele from each parent. So remember when we talked about monogenic and polygenic traits, just depends on the trait that we're talking about. Now there's this idea of complete dominance, which is when one variation of the gene or one allele is dominant over the other. So for example, plant height, tall is dominant over short. And so that means that even though the chromosome that has the one gene on it for plant height, if there's, let's say tall from the mother and short from the father, well, the mother's variation of the trait, the mother's allele, will be dominant because in plant pea plants, tall is dominant over short. All right, page 1.3, the dominant allele is expressed and the recessive allele is masked. So the example explored here, height and pea plants, is determined by a pair of alleles. And we use letters in most cases to talk about the trait. And typically we'll use the letter that's used for the dominant allele. So in this case, tall is dominant over short, so we'll use a T. And we'll use a capital T for dominant and a lowercase t for short. And you'll see, so dominant is gonna be expressed over short. Now, if the offspring only has two short alleles, well then the P will be short. And you'll see this make sense here in a few minutes with the simulation. All right, and that's what we're building up to here. So page 1.4, these are the instructions that tell you how to work this simulation. On the next page, drag pairs of alleles, one from the mom and one from the dad, into the correct Punnett square to determine the phenotypic ratio for the F1 generation for the height, for the trait height, where tall is dominant over short. The F1 generation, F in this case stands for filial, F-I-L. IAL. I don't know if your teacher requires you to know the terminology there, but just in case, that's how it's spelled. And when finished, click reset and try several examples of different parent genotypes. So this is a cool simulation because we get to reset it, and then we're going to get all kinds of different possibilities. Also notice we misspelled Punnett, so I'm going to fix that. All right. Dragging instructions. So on the next page, click an allele to pick it up. Move to the square where it belongs, and click to set down the allele. The short T or tall T will turn gray when placed in the square. So let's see what they're even talking about here. All right, so here's the setup. It says select an allele, then select square where it belongs. Now the way this works, there's some color coding here. Sort of the light blue may represent dad, and then the sort of pinkish color right here represents mom. It doesn't really matter where you put these. You could put dad up here and then mom over here. It honestly doesn't matter. The idea behind the Punnett square is to make a prediction of what the offspring is going to look like. So here you have two pea plants. You have the tall and you have the short. Tall's has, there's a T here, and we're going to click and drag that over to the square. There's another one. Okay. And then to see if we did it correctly, we'll press the play button. So let's try one here. So, all right, so what we're looking at here is, let's say your father, who also has two sets of, I'm sorry, this is your mother, who also has two sets of alleles from her mom and dad on her chromosome that controls for height. She has a tall T, capital T, and another capital T. So from her mother and father, she had a capital T and a capital T. And the way genetics works in mating, when you know a father and the mother mate to produce offspring, you know, it's sort of a 50-50 shot of which of these they're going to pass down to their offspring. So in the case of the mom, in this case, she is what's known as homozygous dominant, because both of her alleles are dominant alleles of the trait for height, whereas the father is heterozygous. So homozygous, homo meaning same, heterozygous meaning different. So father is heterozygous, but he still expresses tall. So in this case, both mom and dad are expressing the tall phenotype. And that term means physical expression, phenotype. It's P-H, not F. And we have that word spelled out here in a few minutes. So anyway, let's try this out. Let's see if we do this right. So let's see. Looks like tall T from mom, tall T from dad. Whoops. Same thing here for this offspring. Oops, I dropped it in the wrong spot. There we go. Okay. And so what this means is if the offspring were to have four children, we're looking at the probability that those four children will be short or tall. Now, what I did is because this row and this column both have tall T's, that means both parents give a tall T to this offspring. Same thing in this one. I have a capital T, I'm calling it tall T, but the same idea. And then there's a capital T over here. So all alleles in this case, in these two offspring, are tall. Homozygous, tall. Now, I'm going to do the row in this one, or I'm sorry, the column in this one first. And now I have a lowercase t. And while I still have the T in my grasp, I'm going to go ahead and drop one right here. And then I know I need, in this column, I need a tall T also. Now, I don't know, you know, how much of a stickler your teacher may be. For me, as long as you have, you've got the representative in this row and the representative from this column covered here, it doesn't really matter what the order is. All right, so now we've got tall T's. We have this offspring, this child plant, is going to be homozygous tall. This one's homozygous tall, heterozygous tall, and heterozygous tall. That means that there is a 100% chance that any offspring produced by these two parents is going to be tall. Their phenotype, their physical expression, is tall. So let's press play and see if we got that right. All right, correct. So we had four tall plants, zero short plants. Again, phenotype refers to the physical expression of the gene, what you see. This is what you see with your own eyes. This is a physical expression of the gene. Genotype is a different concept. Genotype looks at specifically how many of your offspring are homozygous dominant or homozygous recessive, and how many of those offspring are heterozygous. Now, think about what I just said. So you can have homozygous dominant or homozygous recessive, but you can only ever have heterozygous. There's no heterozygous dominant or heterozygous recessive, because heterozygous by nature is always going to be a combination of a dominant and a recessive allele. It's both of those alleles. But because you have a dominant allele, the expression of that trait, the physical expression of that trait, is going to be dominant, because you have one of the two alleles is dominant. Okay, let's try another one of these. All right, so now our parents are different. Mom is homozygous dominant. Dad is homozygous recessive. So let's play the game here. And I'm just going to keep kind of dropping these T's here. And I know I need another tall T there. And another one right here. Oops, there it is. Now, let me explain what I did here. I saw that mom was homozygous dominant, so it was just easier just to go ahead. I know this column, I'm going to have at least one capital T, and this column, I'm going to have at least one capital T per offspring. Now, and the same thing we just saw with mom, we're going to have at least one lowercase t for both mom and dad. I'm sorry, for all four offspring, rather. Oops, I lost my T. Let me grab that and drag this one back over here. Awesome. So let's just double check this. One capital T for each offspring in this column. One capital T for each offspring in this column. In the row, I have one lowercase t in each of the offspring. And in this particular allele, I have one lowercase t in this offspring. So before we move any further, what does this mean for mom? Mom is tall. And what about dad? Dad's not tall. Dad's short. So dad would be this plant. Mom would be that plant. But their offspring, it's a different story. They're all tall. Okay? Their phenotype matches that of mom, not dad. Their genotype, however, is different from both mom and dad. Their genotype is different from both. Mom had both alleles from both her parents were capital T's, dominant. Dad had both his alleles from his mom and dad were both lowercase T's. They were recessive. So dad's expressed phenotype was short. Mom's phenotype was tall. But their genotypes, dad had two lowercase T's. Dad was fully recessive, and mom was dominant. But their kids are all heterozygous. Their genotypes are different than their mom and dad's genotypes. But their physical phenotype, their physical expression, is just like mom's. They're all tall like mom. Okay? All right, now we're going to come back to this simulation several times, but I want to go through a few questions with you. These are questions that will help you think about all the different scenarios and what you might expect. 1.7 says two tall parent pea plants will produce tall offspring. Two tall parent pea plants will produce tall offspring. Well, let's see. Let's see what the options are. I'm going to go and reset this. Okay. Now here's a situation where I have two tall parent pea plants. Remember the capital T, regardless of what both alleles are, as long as one allele is dominant, they're going to express, their phenotype is going to be dominant. So if we play this sort of game again, and we fill in the Punnett square. Very quickly, you'll see that just because mom and dad are both tall does not mean all of the offspring will be tall, or the probability of any one offspring, I should say. So we have, yes, this child would be tall, this child would be tall, that child would be tall, but nope. Right here, we have a short pea plant, okay? So three tall, one short. So going back to this question, we can say that just because there are two tall parent pea plants will produce tall offspring, always, sometimes, never. I think it's a good bet to say sometimes. We saw that here. It was most of the time, but it wasn't always. So the answer here is sometimes. Page 1.8, two short parent pea plants will produce short offspring. Two short parent pea plants will produce short offspring. Well, let's see if we can, I gotta see if I can randomly generate that scenario so we can take a look. Ah, so close. This thing just kind of randomly seeds the parents, so it can be tough to get that particular scenario. But for simplicity's sake, let's just go ahead and mess around with it. Ah, we got pretty close. So let's pretend this one's a lowercase t. There are no capital T's, no capital T's. Well, guess what? All of your squares are going to be lowercase T's, right? So in that case, unlike the first question, which says, hey, I have two tall parent pea plants, they're always going to be tall offspring. We said, no, that's not true. Sometimes they'll be short. But in this case, if both parents are expressing recessive alleles, That must mean there are no dominant alleles available. Therefore, two short parent pea plants will produce short offspring always. They're always going to be short. Okay, page 1.9. One parent pea plant is heterozygous. Remember, that means one capital T, one lowercase t for height. In order to have an equal chance of producing tall or short offspring, the other parent pea plant must be, well, that's a good scenario. Let's go play around with this. So in order to have an equal chance of producing tall or short offspring, the other parent pea plant must be heterozygous, homozygous tall, homozygous short, or the genotype of the other parent does not matter. There can never be an equal chance. Well, we don't know what's true. Let's see if we can reproduce this. So we said one of them was heterozygous, and I need to go back and peek, have an equal chance of producing tall or short offspring. The other pea plant must be. All right, well, let's play this scenario. Let's see. So I'm going to go ahead and fill in the gap, the boxes very quickly here, hopefully. I lost my little T. All right, well, let's see what we get there. All right, I think we found a good scenario for this one. We have two tall and two short, and you can see that in the Punnett square. Each of these offspring are heterozygous, but because they have that dominant allele, the tall T, they're going to be tall. And then these children of the pea plants are lowercase t's, so they're going to be short. So that helps answer this question. We know that in this particular scenario, we have to have the other pea plant has to be homozygous short. Now, what would happen if they were homozygous tall? So, in other words, if you had two capital T's here, you'd have this box would be capital T, this box would be capital T, lowercase t, this would be capital T, and this one would be capital T, lowercase t. In that case, all the phenotypes would be tall, so that doesn't work. And then if we had a heterozygous pea plant, if both of these were heterozygotes, we already looked at that scenario. If mom was heterozygous and dad was heterozygous, then you'd have this. This would be capital T lowercase t, capital T lowercase t, capital T lowercase t, and capital T lowercase t. In that case, all four offspring would be tall. So that scenario doesn't work either. The only scenario where you can have an equal chance of having tall or short would be if one of the parents is heterozygous and the other one is homozygous recessive, or in this case, short. All right, page 1.10. One parent pea plant is homozygous tall. In order to have an equal chance of having tall or short offspring, the other parent pea plant must be, let's see, so one parent pea plant is homozygous tall. Well, we know that that means that parent pea plant has both alleles are dominant. Both alleles are capital T's. Well, we saw that in that scenario, and let's see if I can, here's a good scenario. Mom's got both capital T's. That means all of the offspring, every one of them, are going to be tall. Because look, that T drops down into each of these boxes, and it drops down to each of these boxes. So they're all tall, regardless of what the other parent has. Alright, so let's see, is that what they were asking us? In order to have an equal chance of having tall or short offspring, the other parent pea plant must be. And the answer here is the genotype of the other parent does not matter. There can never be an equal chance, because if you have a homozygous dominant parent, the offspring are always going to be dominant. They're always going to express the dominant allele. Page 111, how many different parent combinations could lead to an equal chance of tall or short offspring? How many different parent combinations could lead to an equal chance of tall or short offspring? That's a really good question. Let's go back up to our Punnett P predictor. So equal chance of tall or short offspring. Let's see. We know if mom is heterozygous and mom or dad, it doesn't matter. And then the other parent is homozygous recessive. If we look here, all of these kids are going to be tall because mom's allele is the tall allele. Whereas these kids are all going to be short. So that's one scenario where you could have that. So that would be one parent's heterozygous, and then the other parent is homozygous recessive. This scenario, everybody's tall because remember, if one parent is homozygous dominant, all the kids are going to express the dominant allele. We already looked at this scenario. Again, we have a homozygous dominant, so that's not going to give us any short plants. Again, we've already looked at that one. You know, there's the mom, if the mom has that same sort of heterozygous, and I'm sorry, the dad has heterozygous, and the mom is homozygous recessive. I mean, that's the same scenario, just both parents reversed. So I'm trying to find the one where both parents are heterozygous and see what here we go. So what would happen here? So both of these kids would be tall, and we already know that one's tall. This one would be tall, but this one would be short. So that doesn't really work either. So in this case, how many different parent combinations could lead to an equal chance of tall or short offspring? Well, because they put parent combinations, I'm going to assume what's meant here is that, okay, we saw the scenario where mom was heterozygous and dad was homozygous recessive. We saw the other scenario where it was reversed. But in both cases, there's an equal chance of tall or short offspring. So we're going to put two here. Because mom can be heterozygous and dad can be homozygous recessive, or dad can be heterozygous and mom can be homozygous recessive. All right, explain your response to the previous question. I think we just did. Again, this is meaning that talks about parent combinations. So the only scenario, there's really only one scenario where you can equal tall and equal short, and that's if one parent's heterozygous and the other parent's homozygous recessive. We said that. We saw that. But it said parent combinations, so that means that there could be, if you're looking at two different sets of parents having baby plants, you could have dad's heterozygous tall, mom's homozygous short. And the other set of parents is where dad is short, homozygous short. And it's kind of redundant to say homozygous recessive because honestly, if we're talking about phenotypic expression. Just being expressing recessive traits means by default that you're homozygous recessive. What we don't know is if you express the dominant gene, you could either be homozygous dominant or heterozygous, which is kind of interesting. So in this particular question, mom or dad has to be heterozygous, and then the other parent has to be homozygous. So that's why I put two there. Okay. Well, with that, that's the end of this particular lesson. I hope you got something out of that. I hope you understand how these kinds of things work now. Please, I encourage you to go to our website. We have trial versions of the software that you can download and use for free. And then you can download this activity off of scienceinspired.com and play with it on your own. And check out all the different combinations. And then, like I said, you know, check out your family, your siblings, check out your friends' parents and siblings and compare your friend to them and see the different traits. It's a lot of fun, pretty cool. And it just goes to show you that genetics is something that's really interesting to learn and you can see it all around you. And so, you know, just knowing that to me seems kind of worth putting in the effort to learn how these rules work. All right. With that, please check out other videos on our YouTube channel and come back and see what's new. Thanks a lot. Bye-bye.